When members of parliament trooped to the House in the afternoon for the debate on the Mao Task Force report and probably the controversial reappointment of Justice Aaron Ringera as the head of the Anti-Graft Commission, it was clear that political deals had been cut. Having failed last Thursday to mobilize the numbers to push for key amendments that would water down the report by the Task Force on the Conservation of Mao Forest, Kalenjin MPs reportedly last evening held a secret meeting that ran late into the night to strategize on how to push through the amendments. During the meeting, reliable sources intimated to Citizen TV that the members of parliament resolved to do a political butter trade with their counterparts from the Mount Kenya region, who are determined to shoot down an attempt by parliament to annul the Gazette notice on the reappointment of Ringera and his two deputies. The deal was to have Mount Kenya members of parliament support the amendments to weaken the task force report, and in return the Kalenjin MPs would go slow on the Ringera issue. And early in the morning, 15 members of parliament from the Mount Kenya region, led by Deputy Prime Minister Uhuru Kenyatta, held a four-hour closed-door meeting at a Nairobi hotel, where the political horse trading deal was reportedly endorsed.
We all woke up to the news that the most important detail for today is Ringera and Mau. And yes, they were amongst the things we talked about them.
Unlike last Thursday, where the Kalenjin MPs lost in their attempt to amend the task force report, the political butter trade had an instant impact, and they easily had their way, with the Mao report undergoing amendments before it was passed. But Environment Minister John Michuki, who has been vocal on the need to conserve the Mao, could not let it go without blowing off the lid on the apparent political butter trade.
If the Ringera issue is more than important than the Mao, where people have to trade an issue like that with the Mao, I must confess I'm ashamed to be in this bunge.
Mr. Speaker, if I've heard the minister correctly, he said that there are people who are trading the Mao for Ringera. Can he please substantiate?
Rather than engage in Ringeras and all these frivolous little issues, we should engage on what is national and international issue.
And so, when the debate on Ringera's reappointment continues tomorrow, the Kalenjin MPs are expected to return the favor to their Mount Kenya counterparts by keeping away from parliament to deny the Orange Democratic Party, whose ministers have openly questioned the president's decision, the numbers to annul the Gazette notice. If the deal works out as planned, it will be yet another classic case of politicians compromising their principles for political expediency. Francis Gashuri, Citizen TV.